Hey, horse people, you're a good boy. I know you miss your buddy. Oh, I'm gonna do a quick one. Got buddy out on a little ride here. Give you a little tip to if you want to work on this. Now again, you need to work on this before you get your horse out in the open and do it in a round pen. But a little farther than a little advancement, instead of riding in a rope halter with no bit, what I've done, if I can get this over here, is I've tied this in a loop around Buddy's neck. So what I'm trying to teach him is get him used to neck reining. So when I lean this way and I push with this leg, he goes that way. And then I leave the reins alone. And then I just kind of walk him off. And we're in a similar road. And if I want him to move to the left of the road, I'm going to pick this rein up, teach him a neck rein, laying that over his neck, pushing, looking that way, and he goes to the left. Then I'll leave him alone. So basically, and then this way I have an emergency brake. Now here comes a car. Let me move out here. Hey, all right, I know. So I can spin this. Hey, he hit some mud there. So I can spin this and actually take his head if I need it. And I'm gonna let this car go by. So I actually can do a one rein stop. So it's like riding with one rein, but I have a loop around his head. So I have this loop here. And so I'm gonna lead him this way. And then I'm gonna give him that rein again. So now I'm not using that. So I'm pulling this way, he's going the other way. I wanna give him, there we go. We moved this way. He didn't go far enough, I'm gonna, hey. There he goes. So now he's going where I want, now I'll let go of this. Now I'm trying to steer him around this mud, because when he gets in the mud, he kind of sinks and kind of jumps. And oh, he found us some good green grass. That's good, we'll give him a chance to talk here. So anyway, what you want to do is get this in a round pen. Now I've already told you, you can ride with a loop around a horse's neck in your round pen. But if your horse doesn't know how to neck rein, doesn't know how to give that pressure, this is kind of one step. And what you want to do when you tie this knot is you want to make the loop big to where almost both loops connect under his chin, like you'd make rope reins. And then you slowly move the knot back, so you have a smaller and smaller loop. I have a pretty big loop here. But as you can tell, to get to this knot over here, oh, and then you want to make sure and tie a knot that works. Because if you don't, then you're going to be one rein riding, which is okay. If you've done your one rein riding, it's not the end of the world. But that wasn't supposed to happen. So I'll have to get off and tie this knot. But and I can't hold this camera and show you how to tie the knot. So, you know, if your knot comes undone, it ain't the end of the world, as long as the rope doesn't fall. And I'll just ride Buddy with the one rein. But again, a little advancement if you want to try something new. Get your horse working off your legs. Ideally, even though you're riding in a rope halter and bitless, your goal should be to use the reins less. Always use the reins less. I want to use my body, my legs, where I'm looking, staying neutral, you know, getting the horse to move with me and off my body versus pulling his head and directing him all the time. You'll never learn how to use it. You know, the old saying, you can't expect your horse to listen to a whisper when you're always yelling at him. Well, kind of what that means is when you're yelling is you've got a pain bit, you're always on the bit, you're always pulling, you're always yanking, you're always, I'm getting a lot of emails about that new Gymkhana or barrel racing series on A&E, and somebody just sent me a picture of a girl in a pink bra, bathing suit top, bikini, bra, whatever, showing off her breastuses with her pink wraps on her horse's leg. Now see, I'm riding Buddy right now, I'm still leaning this over his head because I want to go this way. So even though I'm not pulling a rope, he's giving because I had the loop around him. Now obviously I can't do it this way, but I can. If I just lay this, even though it's not connected, if I give my leg, he'll still follow. So I'm going this way, even though the rope isn't connected. We're coming this way, so people will be like, oh, you're just pulling his head. No, I'm not. I'm giving him a signal. There we go. I gave him his leg. He went. Now I'm going to lay this over his neck, and he's going to come back this way, even though this isn't connected. So Buddy's riding around, doing his own thing, worrying about Mr. T, missing his buddy. So anyway, on that barrel racing, hopefully that will bring Hopefully people will complain. Hopefully people will see how these horses' mouths are getting tore up, how these girls are with these short reins, these short little cute pink reins, are yanking and pulling with these large pain bits, and how the horses' ears are back and their tails loud. And okay, I gotta a horse started running over there, and Buddy's like, hey, let's go over there. Hey, 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 pay attention. Hey, come on, pay attention. I know. Yeah, stop and eat. So anyway, hopefully people will see how those bits and how those horses are just because they're wrapped in pink doesn't mean they've got a good horse life, they're being cared for, and they're not in pain and getting abused and treated rough and manhandled and cowboyed up and all these other cute sayings that they're saying to get women to watch the show or to get men to watch the show for the bras or whatever. So anyway, all right, hope that helps on riding with one rein, riding with a loop tied around your horse's head, and getting your horse used to neck reining. Remember, you'll always tell, everybody tells you their horse is neck reined. If a horse is neck reined, there's no pressure on the nose or bit. The horse goes with a loose rein. If there's pressure on the bit, then the horse is not neck reining. He's being pulled the wrong way. A horse should always follow his head. When I go this way, Buddy's head, hey, pay attention. See his head going the other way? That's not neck reining. See, he's got dogs over there. So this is not neck reining. I'm pulling his head. Hey, pay attention. Hey, knock it off. See, he started paying attention here. So what I'm going to do is I wrap this just around here real quick. Got his nose to where he's flexing. He's not getting his head until he stops pulling. Now he's going to get his head and pay attention a little bit. See, because I'm talking on this thing, the horses are running, things are moving. He's wanting to get back. He can tell I'm not paying attention. He started getting, hey, buddy, knock it off. Ho, you better knock it off. See those ears? You're going to get a beating. Pay attention to me and not those dogs. Now I'm going to lay this rein over his neck and push him to the left, and he shouldn't go. Hey, hey, see that head? See how he follows his head? Come on, this way. See how he follows his head there? Because I'm pulling this way? Ho, ho, hey. I stopped him in the mud. I know, eat your grass so Dad can finish this stupid thing. All right. Anyway, ride and run rein. If you watch that A&E, go to their website and complain about the big bits and the cruelty and the horses being spurred and whipped and hollered and yanked on and spun and raced out of the gate. And you'll see every barrel horse stand. It's enough. You'll see every barrel horse before it starts rearing and jumping. And a lot of people who don't know. Hey, I see there's a lot of people when a horse whinnies, they'll correct it. Kind of give him a yank on the bit or kick him. Tell him not to yell, because when he's yelling, he's not paying attention. That's a little insecure. He wants to go back to Mr. T. So usually right after a whinny, you get movement and not listening. So I'm holding his little head here. He's getting irritated. Well, we quit crying. So that was my little stand. That was my little correction. He wanted to go. He sees a horse, a little pony over there, a little donkey, and the dogs are barking. So he's pretty distracted. And again, I'm not paying attention to him. He can tell that I'm not paying attention to him. I'm not riding him, not giving him direction. I told him to stand, but he needs to stand. But normally when I tell him to stand, I shut up. I'm not talking. So, buddy, stand. Oh, you better watch those ears. Buddy, you're going to... That's right. I ain't playing. You're in big trouble. Dude. All right, back to my thought. Buddy, let me finish here before you keep distracting me. Call A&E and tell them you don't like the big bits and the pain and the horses being spurred and all that on that barrel racing show. And hopefully it'll bring awareness and there'll be some protesters and stuff about the horses being not taken care of just because they're wrapped in pink and the riders wear helmets. That makes them safe and good riders. Whatever. All right, we'll end that there. Buddy, you're a good boy. All right.